My name is Gidon Schickler, play reggae world music, love playing the reggae grooves, conscious lyrics, and spreading it to the masses. I was born in Holland, grew up in California until I was about 14, moved back to Holland for high school, spent lots of time in Israel, came here to university to study photography, back to California another 10 years, and then came back here about 4 years ago to London. I had a very multicultural background musically as well, but when I was about 9, my dad got a Bob Marley Legend tape from my sister, and immediately that was my music. It hit me straight to the heart. I don't know what happened, and from that point on, just discovered more about Jamaican music. As I got older, in my teens, I kind of started discovering my roots a bit more. And a lot of the Jamaican kind of rhythms, for me, they felt like Jewish tunes that I grew up with. This is why when I was younger, it just hit me, and now still, it's the music that kind of lifted me the most. My style of reggae music is unique in the sense that at one hand, I'm staying true to the origins of the fundamentals of the music in terms of rhythm, but I kind of overlay it with the Middle Eastern vibes, chanting, heavy drum and bass and horns, hearing old, you know, the old Jamaican albums. The best ones for me are the ones that have horn sections, you know. It's a regal sound. I felt like that was the foundations of good reggae music. The first song I recorded was a song called Lift Up Your Head, and I wrote it in my dad's house in Laguna Beach, California, and then basically gave it to one of my good friends who's a musician. He was recording with his producer, Ron Aniello, at the time. Next thing I know, I get a call one day. Gidon, we've been sitting in the studio and our friend started singing your song, and the guy turned around and he's like, whose is that? We gotta record that. They basically asked me if they could use my tune for their new album. And at first I was a bit like, I don't know about this, you know, it's my first song, you know, you wanna protect it. But then I thought about the bigger picture, and here I am in my little home studio, whereas I can be in a big studio with someone and learn about that whole process. But I still had some influences, and I played percussion on it and sang some background vocals, and it was a really good experience, you know. That kind of gave me the confidence to say, you know what, this is something that you can really do. I've learned to see myself as a solo artist now, but I love the aspect of working with a band. With my background and moving around a lot, you know, I'm seeing myself as traveling to Israel, London, back to the States, so my idea is to kind of create bands in all these places and have these separate kind of family units, because I love the aspect of creating music together. Turn up the fire strong like a lion. I feel like I've been blessed to have some amazing musical experiences. I remember once in San Francisco, I was playing the saxophone for Hanukkah, and that year Carlos Santana was coming, and we were just blown away, super excited. All of a sudden he came right up to me, and I'm like, nice to meet you, man. He's like, yes, brother, and he put his hand on my heart, and the next thing I know, I'm just like, whoa, flying out of my body, you know, he's talking to me, I just see his mouth moving, and he's like, yes, we're all connected, you know. You could tell he's a big spiritual dude, an amazing person. Coming from California, bringing that vibe to London, I saw that people were really kind of interested in that. I felt like musically this was a great place to be. I also noticed that while I was here, I was a bit unique in my kind of performance to the standard of knowing the classics, but also bringing my own original tunes, and people really latched onto that. I don't wanna work for Babylon. Keep my spirit connected to the one. I think one of the great things about moving here was that there was a big Jamaican base. Even when I go out and play in clubs and where there's mainly Jamaican audiences, I always get, you know, big respect afterwards, and for me that's very humbling. They're like, man, you really do it right, you do it justice. So it is important for me to feel accepted, but I don't really think my music is strictly reggae in terms of something that would come out of Jamaica, you know? But someone who loves reggae music will recognize that it's paying homage to that. At the moment, I'm working on releasing a new EP of new material since I've been in London, and my goal is to start touring this summer. It's all about doing as much as possible. Life is precious, and I'm trying to sow the seeds around the world, and wherever they sprout, I'm gonna go ahead and try to reap the rewards.
Yes.